Hey everybody, it's Monica with Scrapping for My Boys. I'm here to share a project. I was in an altered tea box swap over on the Facebook group, Crafters with Artitude. This swap ends, I still have I think 20 days. I think it ends April 20th, but I wanted to get this done early and get it out the door. So I got my box from Hobby Lobby. And as far as all things go, this is probably a simple project for me. It ended up being a little bit different than I envisioned it, only because certain things just didn't work out the way I wanted it to. So, it's fairly simple. Okay, so here is the top of my box. So this box is 12... just a little under 12. It's 12. It's 12. Just kidding. 12 by, what is that? 7 3/4. I'm not going to show what's inside. I want to leave that as a surprise. It's just a whole bunch of different goodies and embellishments that I'm giving. So all I did to the box was I painted it with black acrylic paint. And I did not put an acrylic finisher on it. I liked the rough texture that it had, and I wanted it to be matte. I didn't have a matte finish acrylic paint sealer or matte Mod Podge, so I just left it as is. And then what I decided to do is I took one of my sprayers, and this one, actually wrong one, this one, and this one is just filled with Lindy's Medieval Gold Mica Powder. Made my own shimmer spritz here. One of my favorite new little bottles. So I sprayed the whole thing so you see the gold shimmer all over the box. So what we have, this part here is actually glass, but I did not like being able to see through it. So I decided to cover it with paper. So this is glitter paper from, this is a Paper Studio glitter pack. It is the one that Shelly gave me for my birthday. So I have this here covering the front, and then I have it also on the inside, the exact same paper. This frame here is from Michaels. This is one of the wood frames. I embossed it with Lindy's Midnight Gold embossing powder. And it's really hard to tell with the light that I got going on here. Let's see if this other one over here might... not really. Oh well. Anyways, so I embossed it, I centered it, I put the B for my partner's name. Her name is Beth. I did the same thing. I embossed it with the same embossing powder, and I put SS4 clear flatback rhinestones. I did the B. Here we have those are SS16s on the corners here. So of course I always use metal. I have my favorite metal corner here, and I actually put them in all four corners. And they have SS8 pointy flatback rhinestones in the two little slots here. So I have some I Am Roses, gardenias, the large ones, and that I sprayed with my cranberry color wash, and then I went over it with the same medieval gold shimmer spray, spritz, all over it. The leaves are the maple leaves from I Am Roses, same thing. I sprayed them with the gold shimmer, so they both have the gold shimmer, and I mirrored the images on each corner. So the metal pieces that I have, on top of the maple leaves, I used one of my favorite leaves, this one here, and then I cupped the ends to be pointing up. Then, tucked in here, behind the flower on both sides, I used this piece, which I absolutely love, but I did not keep it in this shape. I cut it. So I used them like this, with just one piece. So like little petals, and I have them tucked in, peeking outside of the flower. So I cut this one apart. Let's see, what else do we have here? So I had intended on blinging the heck out of this thing, because my partner Beth loves bling as much as I do. But I decided to keep the focus on the corners here. So I just took SS10 flatback clear rhinestones, glass rhinestones, and I just did the same pattern on both sides there. Okay, that is the top of the box. That's it. Then what I did is for the side of the box, I added SS10 bling rhinestones. And these are all glass bling. I don't use acrylic. Acrylic is way too cheap looking. I love the sparkle of the glass bling. So I went around the entire box with the SS10 bling. I didn't put it over the hinges, but I kept the sequins all the way around. So what I have is this lace here. And do I have any? I don't have it out, so I don't want to pull it out. This is some white Venice lace. So what I originally intended, what changed my entire box around, this lace was white, and I sprayed it with my 24K spray that I made. I made it from my Marion Smith Color Lab. This is one of the colors from our recipes. It's a gorgeous goldeny brown. It has no shimmer. I meant to add shimmer afterwards. So I originally wanted the lace to be this color. I was planning on adding additional flowers. They were going to be the cranberry color. I had some other mists that I had made. Like, for example, this is one of the recipes I made myself. This gorgeous blue, and I call it Enchanting Sapphire. I was planning on having this color. I was planning on having, where is that purple at? The color eggplant that I was planning on using. I made a green, which you actually can't see from the bottle because I haven't labeled it, but there's like this foresty green that's gorgeous. And I had intended on using those along with gold and doing a big old cluster in the center and everything. But what I ended up finding out, as this started drying, I sprayed it and it was the color of the 24K. Then as it started drying, it started turning lavender. And I was flipping out at first, I thought, because I was spraying it on top of the same mat that I had colored the flowers in. So I was thinking, oh, I still have the cranberry color wash in there and I mixed it all up. That's why it's changing the color. So I cut another strip for the length of the box and I sprayed it again. Same thing happened. I was so frustrated. And I ended up finding out that, because I asked Marion in our Facebook group, the Color Lab group, why it changed colors. Because I sprayed my Lindy's on it and it, you know, it didn't change. It stayed true to the color on the bottle. I tried my Shimmers paints sprays. Same thing. I sprayed it, color stayed. But any color that I sprayed that I made myself with my Marion Smith Color Lab changed colors. So we ended up finding out is, of course, a lot of laces are bleached, especially if they're white. So in this case, this was chemically treated, whether it was bleach or whatever it was, to keep it as white as it was. Well, Marion Smith's pigments for her sprays and paints and whatever you choose to make them with, they are non-toxic. So they have no type of, what does she describe it as? Other chemicals that some of the other companies use. They say that, you know, they use copper and a few other things. And, you know, in order to be really classified as non-toxic, they omitted those. So the sprays that you make with her Color Lab are completely non-toxic. Other sprayers have other type of chemicals. They have all those metals, copper, and I forget what other things, and other known carcinogens. So, and it's very small amounts, so it's not really going to matter when you're using the spray. It's more like when you're using mass quantities, like when you're making it. Anyways, that's besides the point. So instead of retrying to spray it with a Lindy spray that was similar to the 24K that I wanted to use, I just went with it. So I kept the lavenderish color. I glued it. I have this maroon type of lace. And it's maroon. Like a nice deep rich jewel tone red. I laid that all around it on top. And then I added this nice frilly pleated lace on top of it. And it ended up working out well. Because I did this part before I did the top. So since this ended up being this way, I ended up going with the green and the red. instead of adding the blues and the gold flowers and purples and stuff like that, I just decided to keep it a similar tone. And the gold is on the paper. The last thing that I have is these box corners. Oh, sorry, box feet. Little tiny short ones, so the box doesn't sit on itself. So this is my box. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It was really quick and simple to make, which is kind of what I like. Right now, it's since I'm not crafting much, the quicker I get it done, the better. So here's my project. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions, let me know. And thanks so much for watching. Bye.